I cannot believe this. I don't think I'd get my head around it to go past this door. You know, if people had told me that Jarra was coming to Belfast, I wouldn't have believed it, but they'll be coming up and down the Newton Arms Road. It's fantastic. It'll be a great boost for the whole people of Belfast and the whole cycling community.
How should the cycling community build on this? Because to have Belfast and Northern Ireland and Ireland overall showcased to the cycling fraternity, it has to be built on. There has to be a legacy from the Giro d'Italia.
Yes, there's bound to be a knock on from this event. And what we want to do is now to get into the schools and get cycling as part of a sport. To make people know that there's not just rugby and soccer, there's cycling out there too, and get young people involved in it. And don't forget, there's three Irishmen competing in this. There's Philip Dagenham and there's Nicholas Roach, who's the son of Stephen Roach, in the race, and Dan Martin, who those two boys are both cousins. And both of them have a good chance of getting up in this event, which is one of the most prestigious events in the cycling world.
Give us an idea what spectators should expect.
It'll be a whole cavalcade, it'll be a whole fun. There'll be a lot of the cavalcade of the teams and team riders, and then the race itself. And it'll be phenomenal to see riders competing at that speed.
Who should we look out for?
Well, Cadel Evans has got to be one of the favourites. He won a race at Taranto in Italy there, so he's up there. Also Nicholas Roach, who is now the team leader of his squad. You know, them two people that I think the public here will be shouting for.
Dave, thank you very much for joining us. We'll continue our build-up ahead of the big start on tomorrow's BBC Newsline.
Yes, and tomorrow I will be heading to the North Coast, which is getting ready for cyclists and spectators galore. That's BBC Newsline at 6:30.